Thank you, Lord. Real heroes that allow me and you to live the kind of life that we live. These are my heroes, these people.
They're gonna put me in the movies.
God bless every one of you, and especially our veterans. I love y'all.
I'm sure you're not gonna put this on there.
Say again. My name's Colorado. I've been hunting my whole life, guiding, outfitting, and hunting.
Where in the world?
30 years now, I've made my living outdoors.
Somewhere in the Outback.
We're in Mongolia.
Hello, Argentina.
Right on the El Bicho.
Red Square, Moscow, Russia.
Howdy, Colorado. Welcome to New Zealand.
Where in the world?
I just love it so much. I'm going to keep on loving it if it don't kill me. If I had it my way, I'd take the whole world. What a beautiful place. This week, we're down at the Covenant Ranch in South Texas. A magnificent ranch, a very exciting event. We're down here to hunt white-tailed deer, but we're down here hunting white-tailed deer with our veterans. And we're doing it as part of the Venado Macho, an organization put together by Mr. Mike Levy. This is the first annual Venado Macho Wounded Warriors Hunt here at the Covenant Ranch. What you're going to see is us interacting with people, real heroes, that allow me and you to live the kind of life that we live. These are my heroes, these people. I know you're going to enjoy watching them and hearing some of their stories, watching the interaction. And when this is over, I'm going to have some information ready for you. If you want to help support it, get involved, get ready to get that information. Here is the Venado Macho, first annual Wounded Warrior Hunt.
We started a deer contest 21 years ago called the Venado Macho, and how we came up with that name, they had a sting that they caught a bunch of poachers poaching deer, and the name of the sting was the Venado Macho. Now, Venado Macho means, in Spanish, deer big. So that's what we named it. 7 years ago, we started sponsoring wounded soldiers and their families. And what I mean by sponsoring, all the money that we raise through the entries, through the sponsors that we have, through the awards banquet, 100% of the money goes to the wounded soldier and his family.
Well, this hunt came to be literally about 3 weeks ago. Mr. Levy called me and said that they needed a place to make this soldier hunt happen and asked if we'd be willing to do it. And without question, I jumped right on it and said, absolutely, we can make it happen. And it might be a tough hunt, but we'll try to make it happen the best way we can. So that's how it all came to be. The mission of the ranch is to be a family-based, Christian-based operation. And in the last 5 or 6 years since I took over, we've tried to do as much with wounded warriors, underprivileged teens, and just try to give back to the people that deserve it the most in the best way that we can, and that's through hunting. So that's pretty much the goal of the ranch now, and that's our focus.
Where in the World is Colorado Buck is brought to you by Norma Ammunition, precision ammunition for the serious hunter. Nikon Optics, trust, earn, Nikon. Carlson's Choke Tubes, the shooter's choice. Worldwide Trophy Adventures. The Mule Deer Foundation. Kenitrek Boots. Arms Corps USA and the Ammo and More Store in Stevensville, Montana. And the Colorado Buck Special Edition Rifle by the Montana Rifle Company. This segment brought to you by Norma Ammunition, precision ammunition for the serious hunter.
Where do I begin? I mean, just being asked to come down here is an honor for me. You know, everybody always says, hey, it's an honor to have, you know, combat wounded veterans or just veterans in general, or service members of any branch, whatever, you know. However, what I guess what the public doesn't see is it's actually, I mean, it means a hell of a lot more towards the veterans and that they get invited to do things like this.
Here is just real nice. I get a chance to really escape the world and just come out here and just relax and enjoy nature. This is something that I don't do back home, because every time I'm back home, it's just always on the go. There's always things to do. So I don't get too much to relax back home. But in a place like this, I mean, it's beautiful. The people are real good, and the food is good. The place is beautiful, and everything is just real, real awesome out here. Just a real nice experience being out here, real nice.
Well, it was a great opportunity for us to be able to come here. Mike Levy and the people here at Covenant Farm, they've just went out of their way to treat us great. They've been so good to us, and it's just been a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity. The deer here are absolutely amazing, and we've had a ball, and it's been a real enjoyable trip.
So Mike and I head out to our blind that morning, and we have photos of what the deer would look like. So as the sun's coming up, you see figures moving around out. So we're waiting for the sun to come up till we can truly look at the deer. And we see just as many deer as we could possibly count, but it wasn't our deer. And something spooked that herd off, and they ran off, and we sit there patiently. And within a few minutes, they started to come back in, and Mike leaned over and said, "I think that's your buck walking up." And so I look over to the left, and sure enough, he was coming up from watering hole, and he walked up, and he got into a good position. And again, I placed that 300 Win Mag right where I wanted to hit him. He dropped right in his tracks, so it was an incredible feeling. So the heart pounding, the buck fever, everything, it still happens, and that's what's so cool about it. And just again, I'm very thankful Mike taking his time, and the ranch here giving me the opportunity to come back out and feel like a kid again.
Show him a one shot, one kill.
There you go.
Look at that. You see that?
I'm fixing this. Yeah. Let's go over here and take a look at that.
All right.
Well, what do you think?
That's sweet.
Pretty buck.
How about that, Mr. Mike? Thank you, Mr. Buck. You know who this is for? It's for my brother Brad, too.
Well,
Bradley Thomas.
Yeah, Yes, sir.
It's for him right there. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Well, congratulations. You made a perfect shot on him. That Colorado Buck Special Edition rifle, it puts him down.
I would tell you the recoil on that.
Yeah.
Feels like my 223 or an AR. Very little recoil.
Follow all the action on Facebook at Where in the World is Colorado Buck. This segment brought to you by the Montana Rifle Company, makers of the Colorado Buck Special Edition Rifle.
Thank everybody for being here. This is our first, hopefully annual, for a deer camp, but not on macho, hunting. Hunt. I have some gifts here that I'd like to present to people, and when I call your name, would you please come up? First of all, since we started sponsoring wounded soldiers and their families in our Venado Macho contest, several of what they call challenge coins. And right first, I would like to present this challenge coin to you and thank you, along with the plaque that goes with him. Now, if y'all notice this beautiful little jacket right here, I already given it to him because we had cold weather come in. So you're going to get a travel bag and also a hat to go with it.
Thank you.
And nice. Thank appreciate you. It. Thank you.
Oh, thank you.
Appreciate it.
Thank you. Come here, Mike.
You bet.
Thank you, Mike. Thank you.
You bet. I'd like to give you this challenge coin and tell you thank you very much for coming and sharing this weekend with us. We're really enjoying having you and your brother who's come out, and we appreciate that. And thank you. And we've got this plaque for Jerry. We hope you'll hang that up at your house and think of us every time you see it. And a travel bag. And I appreciate it. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
You bet. Thank you. We'll get you deer tomorrow morning. First of all, I'd like to present you with the coin and tell you thank you very much.
Thanks, sir.
And present you with your travel mug, along with a plaque. We've got you a little jacket.
Nice.
A hat. And the travel bag.
Thank you very much.
You bet. We appreciate y'all coming all the way from Florida.
Well, we really appreciate
and doing
done.
The weekend.
What you've done here is very special.
Well, thank you
very much.
I appreciate it.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Love you, man.
You bet. There's your plaque for Bill. Hat. And looky here, I got you all matching hat, matching jacket, and matching travel.
Thanks, sir.
You bet.
Thank you.
You bet. I appreciate it. Thanks for coming. I don't know if you've ever seen one of those or not, but a few years back when I was, I actually was given one by Bill right there. And since then, we've gotten several over the years of doing this. Those are really pretty special. They really are.
Absolutely. Thank you.
And there's your award. Appreciate what y'all do here with us. And there's your coffee mug, jacket, and travel bag.
Thank you.
Thank you. Clint is the gentleman who actually we had an auction at our awards banquet last year in April, and Clint was the gentleman who bought these hunts for these veterans here. And just want to tell you the same thing. We could never do this without you at all.
It's truly an honor. What we paid for you guys to be able to come down here and enjoy this weekend is nothing compared to what you guys have done for us and my wife, my family, my kids, and myself. We wanted to really extend that to you guys and let you know how much we really appreciate what you guys do, because it takes special people to do what you do. Anybody can do what we do, but it takes a special person to sacrifice like you have for us.
And amen.
We do appreciate it.
Amen.
Where in the World Is Colorado Buck is brought to you by Norma Ammunition, precision ammunition for the serious hunter. Nikon Optics, trust earned. Nikon. Carlson's Choke Tubes, the shooter's choice. Worldwide Trophy Adventures. The Mule Deer Foundation. Kenitrek Boots. Armscore USA and the Ammo and More Store in Stevensville, Montana. And the Colorado Buck Special Edition Rifle by the Montana Rifle Company. This segment brought to you by Nikon Optics. Trust earned. Nikon.
But you know what? It's okay, because I had a real nice time. Right now, I'm going to be able to go home as a new man and relax and face the new world again. And I really, really want to, again, thank everyone that made this possible for us. Thank you.
You know, to me, today was my last day to hunt. We're sitting in our blind. We have this beautiful buck come in, called him Turkey Foot. And he's looking around at all the does and two horned bucks and stuff. And there was a time where maybe I could have taken a shot. However, we decided to wait a tad bit more just so he could get maybe a little bit closer or in a much more better position just so we could broadside it. However, Z and Shane were like, I see two coyotes. And they started getting closer and closer. And that's when all the does just sputtered out of there. You know, they took off. And that one big buck that I was getting ready to shoot pranced off and tried to storm off those coyotes and all. It was a lost chance, but just with the scenery and being able to see these magnificent, beautiful animals, it was a reward in itself. This is the longest I've been in a place where I'm just relaxed, I'm calm, I'm not having any spurts, just random spurts due to PTSD or TBI that I've suffered through.
We had seen him the day before, and we discussed whether or not we were going to have the opportunity to take him, and we kind of got permission to take him, and so we went there looking specifically for him. And as the day started to wind down a little bit, I was thinking, well, we might not get to see him. And then all of a sudden, he appeared out of the brush line. And as he started walking across the field, of course, your heart starts pounding like crazy. And had that big old rack shining in the little bit of sun that was left. And we watched him as he walked across the open field there. And he got out to a position just probably about a little over 200 yards. Took the shot, and fortunately we hit a good hit. It was a quick kill, and it was a great feeling. We had a good time with it, and I'm sure that big old head's gonna look great on my wall.
All of us really do thank Josh Laniger and the Covenant Ranch for what they've done here. This is just such a blessing for us to be able to put this on for them.
Hey, that's a wrap for this week. I do hope you enjoyed this show. Not everybody took home a deer, but everybody did take home a fantastic memory. Memories that they won't forget, and an appreciation on some side for people they didn't really know. They didn't know how much contribution some of our soldiers have made. Some of the soldiers that left here, they left with the happiness, the inner happiness of not taking a deer, but knowing that there's a group of people out there that care, and there are a lot of us. There are a lot of us, aren't there? If you feel anything like I do about our veterans and our wounded warriors, there's some information down here. Contact Venado Macho, Mr. Mike Levy. Get involved. See how you can support him. And most of all, thanks for watching. Please join us next week somewhere in the world for a brand new one. Until then, God bless every one of you, and especially our veterans. I love y'all.
Closed captioning provided by Rocky Top Outfitters. Book your hunt with Colorado today at HeyColoradoBuck.com. We'll see you on the hunt.
Well, now, Rocky is quite a character. I'm sure you're not going to put this on there. Yeah.